sit and I define, let me define the meaning of a public sector, and then after I define private sector, then we look at similarities and differences. Say public sector just refers to, enterprises, organizations, enterprises, entities, which are either entirely or partially under the control of the government. They are operated and managed by the government. These are public sectors. Private sector enterprises, on the other hand, are owned and controlled by groups of individuals or even a single person, a single entity. So members, I think you've understood the meaning of what is a public sector and what is a private sector. I've said that the public sector refers to organizations or enterprises under the control of the state. Why?
That is a public sector.
Public sector are enterprises or organizations. If you want, you can even call them entities under the control of the state, under the control of the government. Those ones who are owned by the government are called public sector enterprises or simply public sector. But private sector, as the word goes, is under the control of the individuals or a person like you and me. Like you have started your school. It is not for government, it is for an individual. That is a private school. That is private sector. So now let us look at similarities and differences between the two. Let us start with similarities. Similarities between public and private sector. Both observe the same functions of management. And my dear students, last time we looked at functions of management in another question. And you are agreeing with me that whether you are in the public sector or private sector, these functions apply. You need them. If the organization is to move from one place to another, if it is to grow, you have to lead, you have to offer leadership. That is a function of management. Besides leading, there is also coordinating. There is also communication. There is also staffing. You need staffing. Staffing is about human resource. You need the workers who are skilled. If they are not skilled, you need to train them. Staffing, coordinating, reading, communication, all those functions of management apply in both sectors. Because even if you are a private sector, these functions help you. Even if you are a public, the same. So both sectors apply functions of management. Number two, both sectors have a hierarchical chain of command. They have a chain of command. There is the lower ladder, the middle ladder, the top ladder. So whether in public or private, there are ladders. Like now in a private school, there is the office of the director, then headmaster, then deputy headmaster, up to the lowest office. Even in public school, it is the same. So the ladders must be followed. Then both exist to serve their clients. And in public sector, the clients are majorly the public. Public sector exists to serve the general public. While private sector also exists to serve the clients when the clients are the customers. Then another one, both apply common techniques. Common techniques like in both accounting, accounting applies. Then budgets, they have to make budgets, budgeting technique. Then internal control mechanism to ensure that the resources are not misused. auditing, they have to audit the books of accounts, whether you are in public or private, for accountability purposes. Like now, during this crisis, whether it is private or public, they are using the same technique of e-learning, IT, information technology, modern techniques like e-learning, e-commerce, e-procurement. So those are the similarities. I repeat, both observe the same functions of management. They have a hierarchical chain of command. Both exist to serve their clients, and both apply common techniques. Let us now go to the differences. And I already discussed these differences, and I add more besides what I included on the PowerPoint. Now, you will agree with me that as far as the public sector is concerned, there is absence of profit motive. For public administration, it acts for the benefit of the people without considering the profit side. But for private administration, it acts at maximizing profits. It offers its service at a fee. It does not engage in ventures which don't generate profits. But for public administration, for instance, look at public entities. For them, they exist to serve the general public, public hospitals, even public schools. Public schools should not be charging too much money. That's why I've said public enterprises are either entirely or partially. Now, like National Water and Sewage Corporation is the public entity, is under public administration. It charges a fee, but a reasonable one. But for private administration, it aims at the maximization of profits. Then number two, another difference is the essentiality of some services. Members, you realize that some services are so essential that they cannot be left to the private sector to provide them. Why? These essential services are a preserve of the public sector or public administration, because public administration its motive is not maximization of profits. But for private administration to not engage in services which take long to generate profits, for instance, road construction. If it engages in road construction, then it is contracted by the public administration. It is still under public administration. Road construction, dam construction, electricity generation. So, you see, some services are essential. That's why we are saying essentiality of some services, that they will be provided by the public sector, not the private sector. Because the public sector, its mind is about the welfare of all the people, unlike the private sector, which is after profits. Then public accountability. Public accountability is so strict with public administration.